It's time for Monday Evening Driver with Jeremiah on Highway 106 and 102.3.
That's a lane no one could do anything with earlier this afternoon. Now it's working. That's the fast lane.
Johnson gets turned. Bain goes around. Buescher is in the outside wall.
You see him crashing down.
Crash
coming up. He's coming up. Coming up.
Martin Truex Jr. is the Monster Energy NASCAR Cup Series champion.
Well, you're used to hearing Monday Evening Driver at this time on Mondays here on the New River Building Supply Afternoon Show, but because the race got postponed and was ran during this time yesterday, we had to push Monday Evening Driver to Tuesday, so we're fixing to talk all things NASCAR with you now. Jeremiah Farmer hanging out with you. I picked Kyle Busch to win yesterday's Brickyard 400, and he looked like he had the car to beat, but had a pit road penalty, got mired back in traffic, and never was able to fully recover. But that number two, Brad Keselowski, came through, and Brad won his first ever Brickyard 400. It was neat to see the first ever Brickyard win for Roger Penske. And now that's two in a row for Brad Keselowski, something that his competition doesn't want to see. Him heating up as they're heading into the playoffs and kind of taking all the all the excitement and the drama that was around the big three of Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, and Martin Truex, and Keselowski saying, "Hey, y'all, I'm here, and I'm coming to play." And, of course, he's a previous NASCAR champion, too, so he knows how to get it done along with those three. And the playoffs are here. The playoffs are underway. The 16 who got in order of their ranking by points, Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, Martin Truex Jr., Brad Keselowski, Clint Bowyer, Joey Logano, Kurt Busch, Chase Elliott, Ryan Blaney, Eric Jones, Austin Dillon, Kyle Larson, Denny Hamlin, Eric Almirola, Jimmy Johnson, and Alex Bowman. Now, of course, it is the elimination style again. They'll run three races, cut four, run three more, cut four, run three more, cut four, and then have a final race with the championship four. The first race in this set of the playoffs is at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. It's the South Point 400, and you'll hear it this Sunday on the highway, courtesy of the Performance Racing Network. It'll be a 2 o'clock airtime, 3 o'clock green flag. And we're first going to make some predictions about who we believe are going to be the first four drivers cut, because that's always interesting. You know, you look at the schedule of three races in this set of the playoffs. You've got Las Vegas, then you've got a short track with Richmond, and then you've got the all-new, brand-new Roval at Charlotte Motor Speedway. And you look at the point standings, and really there's no way. I mean, it would be very hard for Kyle Busch, Kevin Harvick, and Martin Truex not to advance. I mean, they could about run last every race and still advance to the next round. So you start looking at the bottom, and I think one guy who everybody's going to pick to go, and I will too, is Alex Bowman. Just hasn't shown the speed. Great for him to make the playoffs. A great confidence booster. But he, along with most of the Hendrick camp, just hasn't shown the speed. So I'll pick Bowman to get eliminated at the end of this round. I'll also pick Austin Dillon, who currently stands 11th in points, but only by a 5-point margin above 16th. Really hasn't shown a miraculous speed other than that Daytona 500 he won, which he won over Eric Almirola. You remember that way back in February? Now, I thought about picking Almirola to get eliminated, but I'm not going to. I'll tell you why in just a second, because I'm also going to pick Jimmy Johnson to get eliminated. Hard to believe, 7-time eliminated in the first round. But I tell you what, again, he just hasn't showed the speed. At Indy, he was, cracked the top 10 every once in a while, and that was about it. And if he had some good tracks in this first sector of the playoffs, I can imagine picking him to advance. But with this mile and a half, which he needs to capitalize on, that's where he's best, and then a short track at Richmond where he hasn't had that much success, and then a brand new road course, and he's not known for much of a road course racer, it's going to be hard for Jimmy. So I'm going to pick him to get eliminated. And then kind of my surprise pick to not make it out of this round is going to be Ryan Blaney. Kind of started off the year on fire, but really just kind of gets lost in the pack. Just kind of gets lost in the 13th, 14th, 15th range. And again, looking back on how these drivers did at these tracks earlier in the year, I like Eric Almirola to get in and move on over Ryan Blaney. So my four to be eliminated at the end of this round, I'm picking Austin Dillon, Alex Bowman, Jimmy Johnson, and Ryan Blaney did not advance. We'll see how I do when we get 3 weeks from now. But this week we're looking at Las Vegas Motor Speedway. Of course, a kind of a cookie cutter mile and a half. Kevin Harvick won this race back in March. This is the first time that Las Vegas has ever got two races in a year. They got moved to the playoffs from the Brickyard, got moved to the last race before the playoffs, and so first ever fall race at Las Vegas. Nobody has won back-to-back races at Vegas since Jimmy Johnson did it in 2006 and 2007. While I want to pick Harvick, and I think he's going to do really well, and I think all the big three should do really well and just set a point in the precedent and say, hey, guys, we're the best of the best. We're taking it up a notch. I'm going to pick Harvick's teammate, Kurt Busch, from Las Vegas. He's never won at the track. His brother Kyle has won once way back in 2009. But I like Kurt Busch. I think a Las Vegas win would mean a lot to him. He would advance to the next round automatically, and something that I think would be kind of a feather in his cap. So I'm going out on a limb picking the 41 to win this Sunday at Las Vegas. This has been Monday Evening Driver on the New River Building Supply Afternoon Show. Looking forward to the rest of the NASCAR season.